Thanks for staying with us. So we're moving on to Moebebe's ranting on social media. She was ranting about different things. I mean, there are quite a few of them, but we'll take a couple. So the first one was about renting a space in Lagos State that landlords are asking, I assume that you're being sponsored by either your sugar daddy or if you can afford it. Could you share your experience with us and then let's have a conversation around
it. It has been absolute hell. First of all, if you're a single famous woman,
yes,
it's going to be hard to get a place out here in Lagos because I feel they think if you're not married, maybe you're not responsible. Mm. Then if you're now single and famous and also a woman, they think maybe you're promiscuous. Mm. They also think that maybe you'll be doing loads of parties and events in their property. And then the one that totally blew my mind, which you made mention of, was, oh, you must have some sort of sponsor, somebody that's sponsoring your lifestyle. So what about if things don't work out within this year? You're not going to renew. You know,
is that even legal? I mean, is that even right?
It's not legal. You won't let me have anything to say.
Okay. So what are your thoughts on this?
So for me, these are realities that, you know, investors have to deal with when it comes to property. Women who front or they come in with a partner and then they can't continue to maintain the lifestyle and you have already committed to that. So some realities, you talked about sponsors. Mm-hmm. In this business, have you not seen women who small girl big gods?
Of course, but that's not my story.
So the generalization is wrong, but it's happening.
So if it's happening, how do we protect people like Moe and other single, successful, famous women who are trying to get a place in Lagos?
She should be waiting patiently.
I should be waiting.
Until she's understood.
So the reality is that the investor doesn't want their property to get misused. Mm-hmm. The investor doesn't, profiling, this is the negative side of profiling, but there is need for profiling. Mm-hmm. Because if you don't create a profile, you would fall into, you're not learning from previous experience. And as human beings, we are wired to learn from previous experiences. If my neighbor's house got burnt because they turned the house into a meth lab, if I see two young boys that look funky coming to rent my house, profiling will make me say, let me check. Maybe my neighbor's house got burgled because EFCC came there and raided the place and closed down the house.
So shouldn't there be proper measures? If
we want to prevent negative profiling, we need to create a system that provides checks and balance that mm-hmm. I can run a background check on this person without negatively profiling her.
Physically profiling her.
Yes. I can run, there's a structure that I can use to check her credit. I can have a background check confirm her account to know she has a job. Those things are not bad. It's just that many Nigerians feel like, why would you ask her to have a job? If I don't have a job, does that mean I cannot rent her house? Yes. If you don't have a job, you cannot rent a house because the owner of the house is not a charity business.
How you said and you've stressed having a job. And I feel that should be the requirement. Mm-hmm. Not my marital status.
Exactly.
Not whether I have kids. Not whether I'm married.
Exactly.
It doesn't make sense.
Exactly. Lifestyle can be a problem.
No, but I'm seeing if I can pay. She means to pay your rent.
To pay your rent.
If you rent my house, you cannot start... you cannot turn my house into a cooking business place. My house... Like, there are some things, basic things
those
that would say...
Those are clauses in your contracts.
Yes, you must have... So what I believe is, the challenge is because as a society, we don't have systems that protect the landlord. We don't have... our judiciary system is not very effective.
It's not fast.
So the landlord has to now find a way to protect himself. And it is wrong. So to prevent... people from like Moe facing this challenge, and to prevent the landlord also from having to be vetting, the government is going to provide systems in place, and that's the lack of those systems that is making us get into this space entirely. To self-help.
So you can't blame a landlord who has a building and knows that the clause of compensation in his contract to you might not even be enforced. He might be running from court to court and looking for you everywhere.
Blame the landlord for discriminating against me.
Definitely
I can blame the landlord for discriminating. Absolutely.
Property managers will give an acquittance form. That's what I call it.
Yes.
And then you give us, you preload your information ahead of time, voluntarily. Mm-hmm. We check. Some people do interviews. They call a number of families that the landlord can take. Maybe he's building. Like in my house, you're not allowed to use the traditional method of pounding. You can't. I don't want to hear bam bam, and I don't want to see your generators on the balcony. So it's pre done in the
contract. But Nima, let me say something. If we discriminate one, that there's people that don't take Igbos.
Yes.
That's discrimination. That's, so the point is, so how do we then for define...
I've gotten that.
How do we prepare? So that's a problem. Because my mother has had all her, the most, well, aside from this is a district on the left house, all the tenants were Igbos and they're fantastic.
Like, I don't even understand.
Fantastic. So the point I'm trying to make is that if we discriminate a single lady, we discriminate on tribe, we discriminate on religion.
I have had two sets of Igbos. The very first set of Igbos that lived with me made my life a living hell for living in the same building with them. But I have amazing Igbo neighbors now. Yes. In fact, we check up on each other, follow each other on Instagram, and we do things carefully for each other's peace of mind. So, for everybody, their experience. Whatever they, you know, based on that experience initially, the building was empty for 2 years. Because I live in a neighborhood community, and those are the people who will come and rent my building.
Yeah.
So I fact-checked every family to see if you are a normal person. Because I don't want to generalize. I have people, friends, who are doing amazing, but they own their building. And everybody that comes to build, to rent, it seems like they want to destroy the building that they're living in. Till I found that family, I even prayed about it.
So to avoid young people or single women, because this is really what, it's just one category of people. But there are so many categories of people that have been discriminated by landlords.
But you know what? Because Moe is single. She's mature. She's successful and she's Igbo. Famous. So like there are many. You tick all the boxes. You tick all the boxes. And it is extremely wrong because, and you know that generally there's even the one of you, they don't expect a woman to rent a house by herself in Lagos.
I don't get it.
Why? Why? And I used to be, and the truth is I used to be in that space. I feel like if you're a woman, find someone to stay with, don't go and rent your house alone. But as I got older and I've spoken to many other mature women, I realized that people need their space.
Like,
and it's not a crime for you to a mature woman and to live alone. It's not.
So you finally got a place,
a
right?
Girl.
You finally got a place.
Not yet.
Can you imagine?
Honestly. Why is it my landlord's business?
Exactly, Jare, don't mind Nima. But this is your auntie. You never finish your controversy. This is your Ikana.
She wears a tattoo. Not one.
Oh, God.
So, Lala's just looking at her like this, like, Nima.
This is me.
But I'm in the entertainment industry. This is how I
live. Imagine you go for profiling, and you go for interview, and you have like a green hair, and your hair is green.
But my hair is not even green.
And the landlord would have...
So, wait, when you guys get a house, did you take these nails?
Yes.
But wait. Why am I being profiled because of my name?
It doesn't make any sense.
Interestingly,
listen, this goes back to the conversation we had earlier.
The judging.
Concerning the judging.
Why?
Listen, so should she be waiting it out?
I've been squatting somewhere. I think the crazy thing
about this whole thing, I find that it's quite hilarious how I've spoken to a few, like, maybe younger landlords, and they've said that they've actually had more issues with married couples than single.
You see yourself?
So it's almost like...
Yeah, so...
Where do we win?
They're quiet now. They can't talk again. Okay, so if we were to advise Moe as a sister, okay, you want to go and get land. You want to go and get a house, a property.
Remove the nails.
I should wear a ring.
Nima, wait. If we ask her, because the same thing, I want you to put this scenario, like she's going to go and see her mother and say, Mommy, this is my choice on sexuality. The same thing. Are we saying remove your earrings, remove your nails, wear normal hair, and dress, with a nice gown? And I'm just saying like... So is that what you're telling this woman, this young woman who has made a choice to go and meet her mother? Is that what we're asking her to do? They be deceptive.
But when?
Don't call it deception. Don't call it deception. We call it emotional intelligence, understanding how to behave in the right place at the right time.
But I'm already a famous person, and this is what I look like. I think I'm actually a fraud. I'm actually being fraudulent if I come to you and I start wearing
God bless you.
Bring a husband that everybody knows
home. Exactly. I don't have.
Come on.
Hey, I'm going to marry now.
I don't want to yet.
So you see, this conversation, so this is the reality. Oh, that's God, what Amara is saying in the video. This is who I am. Accept me for who I am.
Don't join the issue. Don't join the issue. Don't join the issue. No, don't join the issue. Let's deal with this one. This is a major issue and it is bad. Let's call it speedy speed. It is bad for us to negatively profile. We can link it to answers. You see any young boy sagging jeans, you say it's yahoo yahoo. Any young boy with dreadlocks is yahoo yahoo. This is the major issue that we need to deal with. Yes, we profile to protect ourselves, but we must also not profile in a way that makes people look bad.
Sometimes.
Yes. So
just yesterday, I sat in traffic at Ijora, and there was a boy in traffic trying to get something from a car, I think. And he wore his pants sagging. I could see his underpants clearly, and I could see his skin. I said, this one is on drugs. I hit my bags, my phones immediately. I knew I was at risk. Profiling is security sometimes, you know, and we can't blame these agencies for doing what they do. I think the people who feel that they're in this most times need to, like I said, wait it out. Yes. Or do more to show that you're responsible.
Yes.
So for instance, listen, if I go at you say, what will happen? Wait, you have a landlord and you take your time, approach that landlord and say, please, I know what you're thinking, but this is who I am. And I can do more to show you that I'm who I am. I'm a credible person, I'm credit worthy, I am, you know, trustworthy, I'm everything worthy. I can take care of your building. Even
I'm the landlord. Let's act as if I'm the landlord. You're talking to me. And I'm looking at your hair.
Okay. I'm a popular person, famous person. Yes. I know you're looking at me and thinking I'm single, but I'm single and responsible. I am bank worthy, credit worthy, trustworthy, everything worthy. I can manage your building. And my lifestyle is not, your building is not at any
Madam.
Risk.
You see, all this your nails that you carry, already shows me that you have all sort of friends that come into my house. In fact, my house will be littered with acrylic.
Out of 10, you'll find a different person. Funny, I might just be the one to understand her and say, okay, I'd like to have a neighbor.
I strongly believe that, too. I strongly believe that.
So if you're a landlord and you don't mind a tenant like this, please let us know.
Landlords on the island.
On the island, please.
Another part that we should talk about is, for some people, based on their jobs, they would come back home late. And it doesn't mean they are irresponsible.
Landlord will lock you outside the semester.
Because it is a doctor. Because sometimes you just say that because of entertainment industry.
So that's why you have to pitch it.
Legitimately, entertainment industry tend to hang out late. They have events. But doctors too hang out late because they have to work late.
Exactly.
So let's not just cast everybody that
into one net.
It is wrong. And we must be more open towards, because Yoruba will say, if you close your eye for evil people good to pass, good people will pass and you will miss them as well. So we must be more open as a society, leading with love.
But I have to touch on this comedian's wife, Ali Baba's wife.
Oh, okay.
Did you hear?
Basketman's wife?
Was it Basketman's wife? One of the comedians.
About the nails.
Yeah.
Yes.
You want to go there? It's not hygienic because you can't clean the needful. You can't wash your bum. You can't do any of those things.
Now, this is such a misconception.
Right.
You know, I wish you guys could go on my stories and see that I posted a video where a doctor said how to actually wash your lady parts.
Yes.
And your nails in no way have nothing to do with that.
Now, let me build on that. I don't do my nails. My mom passed recently and I had to do my nails. Unfortunately, this girl did it so well. Mm-hmm. It lasted 4 weeks and I was dreading. I'm like, I can't wait to get this stuff out of it. I mean, I'm still going through the pain. So I want to understand how are you used to it already.
I'm very used to it.
How do you do the needful? I want to know.
Doesn't it enter the nails? Yes, I do.
You cook?
No,
you can't cook. There's no
way.
Are you wearing earrings? That's not a problem.
I actually do cook, and I even have a catering company.
Can you remove your earrings yourself?
Yes, I can.
Can you remove this now?
Mm-hmm.
Is it a lie?
I'm very used to it.
I couldn't wear my earring. Like I could be telling them to come out. It was so difficult. So I get to get used to it.
Yes, you do.
That's me understanding.
Yes.
So
that's you being
so. So therefore, a landlord. So you are a mother, or you are a landlord, and you don't understand the nails.
Mm-hmm.
But you're not asking. Madam, can you clean the house? Can you sweep? Ask questions. Can you do the? Once the woman shows she can, allow her to get rid of the house.
is the same thing in some societies. Being a Muslim girl in some societies is so strange that somebody keeps asking, do you have hair? Do you have
ears? What's inside?
I keep saying to people, if you give me a jewelry set, don't bother with the neck piece. I would not show it.
No.
You know, don't bother. Just a bracelet, anklet is fine. Some people can't even do anklets. Recently, a friend of mine, a medical doctor, and she's already doing her master's, approached a bar in Abuja, and she was kicked out for wearing the hijab.
Really?
Kicked out, as in, after searched, profiled, they went through her bags, and she was traveling through. She was a stopover, she wanted to do a meeting quickly at a cafe. Searched through the bags, see everything. Search her person, she sat down to order. The moment they said that order, they said, madam, can you please vacate this premises? We don't allow people like you here.
Wow. Imagine that.
So, for it's the strangeness.
Discrimination.
Accepting the person because you don't understand them is wrong.
Because, in fact, that is our topic today. That, everything we discuss on
everything is about discrimination.
We're discriminating. Some are saying, wait it out. Accept your discrimination.
Okay, I have waited out a lot of things. I'm enjoying
it. So, are we saying about the Nigerian society? There are some things you ordinarily be discriminated about. Those things you wait. Is that what you say? Well, we wait it out.
So, in fact, I don't take handshake from men.
Yes.
Sometimes I excuse it. Most times I don't. And when I don't, I once you
explain,
I'm a Muslim woman, I don't. If you go further, I think that there's something against, and then I defend myself. I antagonize you immediately. But if you're respectful, you maintain your distance. I'm a friend. And then I'll show you further how interesting the person I can be.
All right, we have to wrap up on this, but let me just come to Moye. What are you working on? Is there anything we should be expecting?
Okay, well, I literally just concluded. Yes, my catering company is still going on. I just concluded my podcast, my visual podcast.
Ah,
it's called Spill the Tea with the Abebes. It's with me and my cousin, Nicole Abebe. And yeah, we basically talk about topics like this, you know, profiling, sex education. Yes, it's on YouTube. Yeah. Just Spill the Tea with the Abebe, so make sure you watch it. I'd love to see what your feedback is.
I didn't hear the number.
Spill the Tea with the Abebe.
Spill the Tea.
The truth is that there are people that fake it, but like, you've always been like this.
I could ask you. When it's something I should ask, we they just judge. You don't understand your lifestyle, ask. Mr. Landlord, ask. Mothers, ask. Fathers, ask. Understand. Because at the end of the day, these are people we love. We care.
They're human beings.
They're human beings like you and I. So if we don't understand, seek to understand. And if you need time, take the time. But don't judge and don't discriminate. On that note, we end this show.
Thank you so much.
Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye for now.